So today is raw meaty bone day. These beautiful joint and knuckle bones are from Harrison, Montana, and they're organically raised. And big, beautiful, raw meaty bones, which I love. And they have that beautiful grass-fed fat on them, which is so important for dogs. The other dogs are outside eating their bones in the grass. Beets isn't allowed a whole bunch of free movement yet outside of a contained area, so she's gated in the kitchen. And the little black and white dog you see behind her is Seeker. He likes to be with her right now wherever she goes, but he's never liked to invest in bones when any of the other dogs are around. For him, there's just like too much pressure in that. But Beets is my bone girl, man. She really loves to get into the bones. And besides this being super nutritious for dogs, it's also considered recreational for them to use their teeth how they were intended. I don't ever buy femur bones, or what is oftentimes referred to as pipe bones or soup bones. That bone density is just way too thick. And I have really robust chewers. Even my puppies, who are just 6.5 months old, they're pretty robust in their chewing. They don't mess around. I don't buy antlers. Those are known to cause huge amounts of slab fractures in dogs' back molars. And I generally stick with joints or whole carcasses, like if it's a whole frozen raw sardine, but those bones are pretty tiny and not recreational. That's a meal. Sometimes I will buy a whole rabbit with head and pelt removed, and those bones are pretty easy to negotiate. And then other times I'll buy a whole raw Cornish game hen, sans feathers and head, and they can negotiate that as well. The puppies get half a Cornish game hen, the adult dogs get a whole one. And the nice thing about this old floor in here is after she's done chewing, it'll be super easy to clean up. And so my rule of thumb for bones is, when you're out hiking and you see a coyote kill and what a coyote has left behind, those are the same bones you would not feed your dog. So say you come upon or wander upon a deer carcass or part of a deer carcass, generally what's left over is the vertebrae, the pelvic, the femur, and part of the skull. What's missing are the joint bones, the lower trotters, the hooves, the scapula, and the muzzle. And so those are the bones that I look for to also feed my dogs. If the bone density is too thick, it can harm your dog's teeth, especially as they start to age and stuff. So anyway, happy bone day. Beetsers, you want to show everyone how much you love your bone? And these have just the perfect amount of meat on them.